Metropolitan newspaper celebrates 40 years of not being on TV. Need some help scoring an internship? MSU Denver has the workshops to get you started. Ever wish you could get away? Commercial spaceflight is taking off with Virgin Galactic leading the way. Local upcoming band Poor Moxie gives Met Media an exclusive interview before going on tour. Michael Cohen delivers an apologetic and fiery testimony on potential presidential campaign finance violations. Stay gold and pretty boy, Rockies sign 8-year contract with Nolan Arenado.
We're looking at a heavy weekend of snow coming up, but just how cold is it really going to get? I'll let you know coming up on The Met Report.
Thanks for joining us on The Met Report. I'm Corey O'Leary.
And I'm Yekta Skandari. A Denver student has taken his future into his own hands. Cameron Hadley, a student from Rocky Mountain College of Art and Design, is creating his own unique platform to share his passion. Photography, fashion, and YouTube videos are just some of his many crafts. He gives credit to his individuality, originality to reach his followers. Hadley hopes to inspire students to follow their dreams, and even if they aren't sure of it yet.
I know it's a lot harder to take your own advice rather than just to say it, you know what I mean? But I think if I were to tell anyone, honestly, out there, not even just students, just people out there who feel like they're struggling or people who feel like they're like coming short, is that you can breathe and just stop being so hard on yourself, because I think that's something I need to kind of like take more into consideration. And brush your teeth, I swear, like you'll feel better if you brush your teeth and your breath won't stink, so.
If you're a junior or senior, you know the pressure of hunting down internships. Located on the third floor of the admission building, the MSU internship office offers workshops throughout the semester. If you can't attend a workshop, make an appointment or just walk in. One of the many staff members will be happy to assist you. They can help you improve the appearance of your resume, interview preparation, and other internship search skills. Jamie Flores was willing to give us some words of advice.
Students should start looking for internships sooner rather than later, honestly. I didn't understand how important it was till I started working here. So here they can find like basic help that you wouldn't necessarily find anywhere else, I would say. We help with resumes, cover letter, mock interviews, sort of general information that you wouldn't necessarily get anywhere else.
For more information, go to msudenver.edu/internship.
Thing students want to deal with after college is being in debt. Allison Negrete tells us more about how applying for scholarships can decrease that. For some, the task of applying for scholarships with long essays can seem daunting. The Financial Aid and Scholarships Department at MSU Denver held a scholarship workshop event to help students apply. Is that me?
So what we have done is revitalize how we ask students to tell us their story through the scholarship process. And so we've been holding these workshops about once a week for the last 6 weeks. And it's just so that they can get more guidance on how to complete our general scholarship application.
This spring, students have access to new technologies through the Auraria Campus Library. The Auraria Make Lab recently moved to a new room inside the library. The lab provides digital media services for students, school projects, and has multiple scanners, large format printers, and vinyl plotters. The lab also has multiple 3D printers available for use at 3 cents per minute. Many of these services were previously available in the digital media studio. The new location is next to the west entrance and is open weekdays 9 to 5 and Fridays 10 to 3.
It's a big milestone for our Met Media staff as the Metropolitan hit its 40-year anniversary. The Metropolitan first started on February 20th, 1979, and was founded by four men by the names of Emerson Schwarzkopf, Peter Duray Beto, Steve Werges, and Frank Mullen. The event had alumni from years in the past talking about their experiences working with our historic paper. The 40th anniversary event had live music, guest speakers, and photo booths, and much more. We talked to the new editor-in-chief on what he thought about the event.
It was really cool. I put so much time into the newspaper the last 2 years. I've had so many sleepless nights here. It's pretty rewarding to see people come out and support us.
Well, you guys, I'm so excited for this weekend, but I have a feeling it's going to be super cold. Alina, what can you tell us about the weather?
Well, you are definitely going to be feeling some snow out there. I will let you know right now. It's going to be a busy week. So looking at our radar and satellite, as you can see, there are going to be some snowy, cold fronts up in the high country, as well as some rainy fronts in Greeley. Looking at our current conditions, it's about 39 degrees. Feels like 28 though, so I would definitely keep a jacket with you as it is gonna be a little chillier. Our day planner is as follows. It's about 39 around 4 p.m., but check it out. It drops pretty drastically around 8 p.m., so you're definitely wanna maybe stay in tonight instead of going out. Today we're about 50 degrees. It's looking pretty cloudy out right now. You're probably not gonna need those sunnies or sunglasses. The wind's coming in from the east. And what's to come, I'll let you know. We're gonna have some weekend snow, and I'll dive right into our 7-day forecast as well as our photo of the week. Stay with us, we'll be right back.
Hello, my name's Adele, and I invented this product, the Lovey Window. I invented this in preschool when I was at nap time, and I thought, why can't I see my Lovey in the day without taking it out? So I could see my Lovey the entire day. If you have a normal backpack, I can't see my Lovey, I can't hear my Lovey, I can't play with my Lovey, and that Lovey can't see me, can't hear me, feel it. But if they have this, they can see you and have more light and not be scared. So if you want to see your Lovey in the middle of the day, you have to have this backpack, and so you can see the Lovey. Thank you.
Dumb ways to die. Don't let it be around buses and trains. Be safe around buses and trains. A message from RTD.
So many dumb ways to die.
Met Radio on mymetmedia.com.
Some viewers may find this content unsuitable for younger audiences. Viewer discretion is advised. Opioids have been a huge problem in the United States for several years, resulting in many deaths and addictions. It turns out that the African American community has been hit especially hard by opioids. According to NBC News, the death rate from opioids in the District of Columbia, where nearly half the residents are black, has tripled every year since 2013. One reason is because of the wide availability of heroin.
After 30 years of accusations of sexual assault against underage minor, R. Kelly turned himself in to the authorities in the city of Chicago on February 22, 2019. According to CNN, R. Kelly has been indicted on 10 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse. As of Monday, February 25th, R. Kelly has not pled guilty to counts of sexual abuse and stated by the Associated Press, he is now released on a $100,000 bond.
Have you ever wondered what it would be like to take a flight to space? Well, if so, you're in luck. Virgin Galactic had its second successful launch in their supersonic space plane, the VSS Unity, last Friday. The Galactic team set a new altitude record, climbing to 56 miles above the Earth's surface. The Unity's two pilots, along with its first ever passenger, Beth Moses, will receive commercial astronaut wings from the Federal Aviation Administration for the flight. She is the first woman to earn the FAA accreditation. With the success of its back-to-back test flights, Virgin Galactic could be offering commercial flights to space by the end of the year. Reserved flights on the Unity have prices ranging from $200,000 to $250,000 per seat. So if you don't know what to get your significant other for their birthday or Christmas this year, your options are now out of this world.
The Rosenberg crime spree has reached its final destination. Matthew Finelli, Jose Lopez Hiovel were finally taken into police custody after an attempted carjacking involving gunfire on Interstate 5. The two men were connected to a crime spree in Colorado, Wyoming, and Utah. According to sources, the two men were not traveling alone. They were accompanied by 19-year-old Cynthia Cena. The suspects went on the run after instigating a shooting at Deja Vu Showgirls Friday morning in Colorado Springs. The final verdict of the suspects' charges will be determined later on this week.
Driving under the influence is one of the main causes of fatal crashes and death. In Colorado, receiving a DUI counts as a misdemeanor offense that doesn't always result in just a ticket. It can also lead to a criminal record and driver's license suspension of up to 1 year. According to Colorado DUI offense lawyers, a first DUI offense will result in the following: 5 days to 1 year in jail, a fine of $600 to $1,000, and 48 to 96 hours of community service. The more DUI offenses a driver has, the more jail time and more community service hours a driver will face, as well as higher fees. The local band Poor Moxie has come a long way since high school, becoming familiar faces in the local Denver musical scene.
We are Poor Moxie. We joined together at the very end of our senior year, so spring of 2017, to audition to play at our school's graduation. And after we didn't get that, out of spite, we are like, you know what? We're gonna just throw our own show. And so we put together some shows in the garage and invited a bunch of our friends. And, you know, being a musician is a wonderful feeling, especially when you have that love for music, but it's definitely a lot of work if you want to make it anywhere.
I think definitely, like, being in a band, I've said, is like almost like a second job. It's kind of like starting a business.
I've known my entire life I wanted to be a musician, and as I got older, it started to form into, okay, I want to be in a band, and I want to be a rock musician. And I did not realize how difficult it would be until I started the process of writing songs and booking gigs and dealing with booking agents and other bands.
It's so much better to hear the music come to life when you're playing it together with actual people instead of recording each bit like on your own, and like you can tweak everything you want in post, but when you actually like hear that music come to life, it's really, I don't know, it's a good experience.
With us, I'm Alina Howder, and here's the weather. As you can see, we are under a winter weather advisory. Everywhere in the pink, they are going to be seeing up to 1 to 2 feet of snow. So if you are going to the high country, please make sure that you are being safe. Here in Denver, we will be experiencing about 3 to 6 inches of snow. As you can see, during the next 48 hours, we will be undergoing some winter fronts. You'll see some snow traveling in from the high country to Denver. This is going to about Saturday tomorrow around maybe 9 p.m. And then our temperatures across our lovely state of Colorado, they'll be around 30 degrees in the mountains. It's gonna be a little cooler up there, but as you can see down in Pueblo and Trinidad, it's gonna be a little warmer with those temperatures up in the 60s.
And then we also will be feeling a little chillier tonight. It's going to be about 24 degrees. The clouds will be clearing pretty late, so make sure you do keep that jacket with you if you're going out tonight and having some fun. And now on to our 7-day forecast. As you can see, we are experiencing some snow this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. And keep that in mind for your commute to your work week, as you will see some black ice. The snow will probably make the roads pretty dicey out there. And our lovely photo of the week comes to you from Denver, Colorado. This is from Nathaniel Ortega. We would love to see your pictures. So if you have anything that you would like to send us, please send it to us on our Facebook page or our Twitter. And you can also see our show on our website at mymetmedia.com. Thank you so much. Stay with us after the break.
Is a fun, enjoyable activity, but it can also be very dangerous if you don't know how to do life-saving skills. And so that's what swimming lessons is. It can be that extra protection against the threats of water. And so here at Aquatot Swim School, it's gonna teach those little ones to be confident in the water, having no fear and anxiety. We're gonna be working on basic foundational swimming skills.
When we are doing our level 3 classes, so this is our foundational class, so they will do some jumping in, turning around, and finding a wall. Swimming year-round helps the kids retain all of their swim skills that they're learned throughout their swimming lessons. So if they're swimming year-round, they are able to keep making that progress without having to track back if they're coming out and going back in.
Why are you reading that trash? Read the Metrosphere.
Metrosphere is a magazine that highlights art, literature, and culture on the Arroyo campus and the surrounding Denver area, created by journalism students while featuring work from English, art, journalism, and design students.
Who are you talking to?
Welcome to the new Met Report political segment. I'm Bobby Bennett. The Electoral College has been a staple of American democracy. However, Colorado is joining a new movement to change the way electoral votes are awarded. This week, Colorado lawmakers passed a bill that would award Colorado's 9 Electoral College votes to the winner of the national popular vote. Colorado Governor Jared Polis is expected to sign the bill into law. In an interview on Sunday, Governor Polis called the Electoral College an undemocratic relic, one of our nation's past, one that has long since overstayed its welcome and should be in the garbage of our history. This week, President Trump's former fixer Michael Cohen testified before Congress. Cohen, who has worked as a personal attorney to President Trump, has pled guilty to lying to Congress about the Russian investigation. On Wednesday, Cohen testified in front of members of the House Oversight Committee that consists of Congress members such as Committee Chairman Elijah Cummings of Maryland's 7th District, Rashida Tlaib of Michigan's 13th District, and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez of New York's 14th District.
Driving through a struggling neighborhood in Chicago, he commented that only black people could live that way. And he told me that black people would never vote for him because they were too stupid. He is a racist, he is a con man, and he is a cheat.
Finally, Republican Senator Lamar Alexander of Tennessee has introduced a bill that would radically alter how we as students pay back our student loan debt. Take a look.
A new controversial plan is being introduced to deal with America's student loan debt crisis. Close to 44 million Americans are affected by student loan debt. Student loan debt has steadily increased over the last 9 years to $1.5 trillion, and One in five borrowers are in default of their federal loans, according to the National Consumer Law Center. A new proposal from Republican Senator Lamar Alexander of Tennessee calls for an update to the Higher Education Act. Borrowers currently have several payback options, but the new bill would slash those options to only two. The first plan would be a standard 10-year repayment plan. Bills would be capped at 10% of your income. The second would be a pay-as-you-earn plan spread out over 10 years, where employers would withdraw funds from their employees' paychecks and send the money to the federal government. Now, here's the reaction from students on campus.
Well, what I think about the new bill, I think it's, like, I guess not okay because a lot of people use that for other things. Maybe they have children. Maybe they have places, things to pay for, bills to pay for, especially rent. The rent in Denver is super high.
It would not help me in any way for that bill to pass. Just because somebody like me who's out on their own and doing, like, I'm literally paying for my living on my own, my car on my own. So taking that money out of my check would not benefit me, like, at all.
Backers of the plan say it would help keep borrowers from falling behind, and it would lower the risk of going into default. But people against the plan say that it doesn't give borrowers the right to prioritize their own expenses, such as rent and food.
Tune in next week for a story explaining how the National Popular Vote Bill works and for an update on the situation in Venezuela. For the Met Report, I'm Bobby Bennett.
Local news or world news, the Met Report delivers. Along with politics, sports, entertainment, and weather, our Student Emmy Award-winning newscast features only the best. Tune in live to the Met Report every Friday at 12:30 p.m. on Campus Channel 20, Comcast Channel 58, or MyMetMedia.com.
At Metropolitan State University of Denver, our mission is to provide high-quality, accessible education that prepares our students for successful careers, postgraduate education, and lifelong learning in a global and technological society. Our values of diversity, access, and community help us provide opportunities for our students from all over the globe. In fact, we've just been named a diversity champion by Insight into Diversity magazine for 2016. Because at MSU Denver, we believe in transforming lives.
It's fine that other people like you. It's more important that you like yourself. And I'm comfortable with every part of me. Meals on Wheels coming to my door as someone who's housebound assures me that I'm not forgotten. They care that I'm okay. My name is Asha Ida Bell. America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
We'll be right back.
everybody. I'm Gloria Morelia, and here are your weekly news sports. The Patriots owner solicited prostitution at Orchids of Asia Day Spa in Florida just hours before the Patriots participated in the AFC Championship game, where they defeated the Kansas City Chiefs. Kraft is one of the 25 men charged as a result of the investigation, along with other people accused of running illicit operations. If Kraft is convicted, he could possibly face either 1 year in jail, a $5,000 fine, or 100 hours of community service, and will have to attend human trafficking dangerous class. Good news, Rockies fans. The Rockies are stacking up for the upcoming season as they extend Bud Black and Nolan Arenado's contracts. Earlier this week, General Manager Jeff Breidich announced Black's extension through the 2022 season. Now off Bud Black and the man of the moment, Nolan Arenado. Arenado signed a history-breaking contract worth $260 million for 8 years with an option to opt out after the 2021 season.
First of all, I just want to thank God for this unbelievable blessing. It's amazing. A lot of hard work, but I've been healthy, and I thank God for those things and for the people that have helped me and pushed me and get me better. I really appreciate it.
Roadrunners are breaking records, and Adame is the first of us to hit for the cycle.
2019 Roadrunners Baseball is underway, and senior Draven Adame has already made it into the record books for completing the first cycle in team history. I was able to catch up to Draven to ask how it feels to be in the books and to talk about the pressures of being a student athlete.
It's just awesome, you know. I didn't think that I'd be coming in as a junior, you know, being in the books for anything, because obviously most of the people that are in the books are here for 4 years, you know, and they, for the most part, are some of the best players that have even come through here, so it's good to be a part of that. You know, after this, so I'm just going to finish up this semester, and hopefully I can find a job. At the end of things, I want to be an athletic director, either out of high school or in college. It's a good balance. I mean, coming out for baseball every day, practice, and playing the game, just trying to finish up everything. It's awesome. Can't complain with a little bit of homework, you know. It just comes with school, but for the most part, I do fairly well, so I can't complain about anything.
Draven even had some words of wisdom for future Roadrunner athletes.
You know, just come in and do what you can do. Don't try to do too much. That was a big thing. Like last year I had a kind of rough year, but this year I just came in with a lot of confidence and just kind of controlled the controllables, you know. I wasn't trying to do too much, and that's the biggest thing. Just have confidence in everything that you do, and yeah, just stay on top of school, and obviously everything will work out in the end.
Reporting from the Regency Sports Complex for Met TV Sports, I'm David Mann.
So, do you guys have anything planned with the snowy weekend coming up?
Actually, yes. I was thinking about going to the Rapids home opener tomorrow, but it's going to be a little chilly, so I don't know if I may or may not go.
You'll definitely have to wear a jacket tomorrow.
That's true. All right, well, that's all the time we have today on the Met Report.
Don't forget to follow us on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages.
Bye, guys.